Look up from your telescope. Take me on this journey home. I don't wanna wait no more. All right, y'all, you already know by the title of this video that this is my episode 12 synopsis breakdown. Let's get into this fallout of Olivia leaking this freaking body cam footage and declaring war on Laura Baker. Whoo, child. All right, if you are new here, my name is Erica Vane, and I cover All American in depth. So deep, child. I post new videos every day, sometimes multiple times a day, specifically about All American. And that is in addition to the other television series that I'm covering, entertainment news that I'm covering, as well as film reviews. So go ahead and click that subscribe button. I promise you're going to love it here. We have the best All American community on the internet. We are growing the general entertainment community where we can just have amazing conversations around the things that are entertaining us, educating us, aspiring, building aspiration in us. Like, just go ahead and click the subscribe button, child. It's a good move. If you haven't already, I have posted quite a few videos post episode 11. So I have my episode 11 breakdown that you can check out. But then I also made separate videos to go into the major things that presented themselves in episode 11. So is Billy suffering from CTE? You can check that out. Should Olivia have stolen the body cam footage? You can check that out. Let's talk about Laura Baker, because there's a lot of questions that I have, but then also a lot that needs to be discussed when it comes to Laura Baker and how we move forward. Because whether y'all want to believe it or not, it was for a good reason. She had really great intentions, but Olivia's act of stealing the body cam footage and leaking it is a problem on multiple fronts. And I created the Let's Talk About Laura Baker video because I wanted to talk about the impact of that action on her personally and within the family interpersonal dynamic. So check out all of those videos. I'll have them linked in the cards above as well as the description box down below. So after this video, you can go ahead and get a little bit more context. I think it's definitely going to help when we are preparing to watch episode 12. But let's read the synopsis. When the truth comes out, Laura is furious and is left to face the consequences. Seeing everything going on, Spencer doesn't want to sit on the sidelines and ask something of his teammates that could jeopardize the rest of their season. Billy deals with something personal by himself, but after a conversation with his dad, he realizes what has really happened. Meanwhile, Simone is worried about Jordan and turns to his friends for help. Layla, Asher, Coop, and Grace will also be in this episode. All right, y'all, you know how I do. I take it line by line and tell you what I think the actual lines in the synopsis mean. These are just my predictions. These are not facts. These are based off of what I perceive to be going on and will happen moving forward. And at any point, you can drop down into the comment section and tell me what you think. Okay, so when the truth comes out, Laura is furious and is left to face the consequences. Y'all, you really, 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 really have to watch my Let's Talk About Laura Baker video, as well as my Should Olivia Have Stolen the Body Cam video, because those two videos go hand in hand and it talks about literally all of the positives and negatives of this actual act, y'all. This is going to have so many ramifications for Laura and for everyone. I also did an interview breakdown where I talked about an interview that the showrunner NK did with TV Guide. I actually created a video around that where she actually gave a little bit more clarity to the rest of the season and what we can expect without giving us any real spoilers. But she mentions this as well in reference to Olivia stealing this body cam footage and leaking it is going to have ramifications for everyone. It is a problem for everyone, not just for Laura and her job, but it's going to affect Spencer. It's going to affect Billy. It's going to, for me personally, like, I really dial into interpersonal relationships. Like, that's one of the things that I love about the drama genre. And I instantly went to the feelings behind this, right? So, like, how does Laura feel with her daughter compromising her career in this way? How does she feel with her daughter betraying her this way after she has tried her best to show up as best as she could for her daughter in her daughter's moments in times of need? For a second, let's put aside the fact that Laura is the DA. You know, she did have access to this footage and she could have released it on her own. Just looking at this as her daughter took advantage of her proximity and privilege to be able to have access to this and decided to make a choice disregarding the wishes, the feelings, or the consequences that Laura would have to endure because of that decision, that is a freaking heavy weight to bear. And I could definitely see Laura and Olivia's relationship starting to struggle, and it's already not even in the best place. Like, Olivia feels very alone. She feels like the family doesn't necessarily take care or check in or support her in the ways that they should. And while Laura is doing her best and realizing her shortcomings, this ain't gonna help. Like, this is, child, this family, the Bakers, apparently this is about to be their moment. We didn't had the moment of Spencer struggling with not knowing where his dad is. His dad don't want him. His dad want to bring another kid around to replace him. His dad just died. All of these things. Apparently this is now the Baker season to be in some mess, child, because we got this happening between Laura and Olivia, which is going to spiral out and affect everybody. We got Billy over here dealing with whatever's going on in his head by himself. We got Jordan, he's married and he can't play football no more, and that's all coming out. The Bakers are in trouble, child. You are in trouble, child. And I think that that's what this line really just speaks to. Laura is going to have to deal with the consequences. Now, everyone's saying that Laura's going to get fired. I don't think that she's going to get fired. And I also think that she is still going to protect Olivia and not allow anything to happen to her by way of consequences for Olivia specifically. I think the biggest fallout that's going to happen is the mistrust and the tension that's going to develop between Laura and Olivia within their relationship. I do think that Laura is going to be able to navigate out of this in some way. I hope that the case is not going to be taken away from her, but maybe that, like, maybe the case is going to be removed from her charge, but I don't think that Laura is going to get fired as DA. Like, I definitely think that would be a wrongful termination situation because she did not do anything wrong. Olivia literally stole the footage. The same way that anybody who would have broken into her house could have stolen the footage. Now her daughter does know a little bit something more about her. And clearly, y'all Bakers don't like to have secure passwords, because this is the second time that Olivia didn't crack the code, child. Y'all need to get a little bit more secure. And seeing everything going on, Spencer doesn't want to sit on the sidelines and ask something of his teammates that could jeopardize the rest of their season. I'm not even gonna hold y'all. I am so preoccupied with what's going on at the Baker Mansion that I don't even got the time or the energy or the thought to understand what the hell is Spencer doing now. Like, Spence, you just had the game of your career. You're back on College Scouts radars. Sir, we do not need you compromising yourself or the rest of the team. What is the problem? I think that if I had to say something that I think is going to happen, because y'all, for real, I really just haven't given this that much thought, but I think maybe Spencer's going to ask them to sit out. I think Spencer's going to ask them to not play in their next games, to make a statement or to do something a little bit along those lines, activism wise and in support or solidarity wise, which definitely could compromise, you know, seniors who are trying to get scholarships just like himself, as well as the other players. Other than that, I can't really imagine what the thing would be that would actually have them compromise their season. If they don't play and they forfeit a game, then they will be out. So, damn, maybe they can't do that, because I know he definitely still wants to make it to playoffs. So maybe they can't sit out a game. They are actually going to play. I don't know. Y'all can help me out down in the comment section below. I am stumped. What do you think that Spencer is going to do that is asking a lot of his teammates and potentially going to jeopardize the rest of their season? Pause the video and tell me in the comment section down below. I can't wait to see what y'all come up with. And then Billy deals with something personal by himself, but after a conversation with his dad, he realizes what has really happened. Child, it is about time. We about to get the backstory on Billy and his mom and his dad and what actually happened. This is what we can see in the trailer, where Billy is getting a CT scan of his brain and he is learning what is actually going on, and maybe he gets a little bit more info into why he doesn't remember beating the hell out of Carter. But you know, apparently he did beat the hell out of Carter. Coach Raggedy Romero confirmed that for us, and that was the best thing that you could possibly do in the episode, because other than trying to push bad boy Spencer James, sir, we really didn't need you. But anyway, I digress. We are definitely going to see Billy dealing with that one alone. He's trying to get to the bottom of why he doesn't remember these things that have happened, and that leads him back to his dad. And I did make the video about, is Billy struggling with CTE, but even in that video I go into depth about why I feel like it's something else and why it's deeper trauma. So you could definitely watch that video. I think that we're going to start to get the answers that we're looking for in reference to that. I definitely think the trauma around his mother's death is something that Billy is struggling with in reference to repressed emotions, as well as repressed memories behind specific situations. And his dad is a perfect person to provide that context because his dad was there. We saw early on in season 3 that he resents his dad for how he handled his mom's sickness, but we don't know the details around that. And I think in this episode, we are going to start to get the details around that. And I can't wait. I'm here for GW and Billy working out their issues because, child, I'm tired. By now, Laura needs to be invited to the cookout because she done been through hell and back with you bakers. Meanwhile, Simone is worried about Jordan and turns to his friends for help. Okay, we're going to have a little cute Jermone moment. I'm here for it. I mean, he got off the couch in the last episode, so maybe this is just trying to get him back onto the field. Not playing intensely, but playing to the point where he can enjoy it again. I can definitely see Jordan is going to be wavering in and out of depression and really just trying to make sense of what his life looks like now, even with Laura trying to have them have their marriage and all, which maybe Olivia doing this is going to put a hold on Laura's focus on their annulment so they can actually have that for a little bit longer. But I can definitely see Simone trying to, you know, let him know that everything's going to be okay. And y'all, all I'm seeing from this little line in this little synopsis is that we still getting Jermone. And y'all know I stan Jermone and that I would love to see them do a long distance relationship. So when she goes to All-American Homecoming, she is still very much so with Jordan and making Jordan better because Jordan is a little raggedy piece of, you know what, when he don't have his Simone. I said what I said, but I literally just see that they're still together and they're going to be together and they're going to work it out. And they have been, honestly, y'all, they have been such a solid couple this season, even with the struggles and the things that they didn't know and things coming about and the fights that they have had. They have worked through it so beautifully and so healthily. Whew. I love to see it. Shout out to Jermone. I'm here for it. And y'all can continue to hate all y'all want, but it's like 3 of the subbies who be with me. So, you know, we gonna rock out with our, you know, hashtag Jermone love. Asher, Layla, Coop, and Grace are also in this episode. And I think that we're just really gonna see a lot of the subsidiary stories from them. I think we might see Layla try to show up and support Olivia after figuring out that Olivia is the one who actually did this. I don't know what Asher's gonna say, but I hope he just doesn't bring Vanessa with him. Like, hopefully he comes to support Olivia as well, but he could also be just a part of the people who are trying to get Jordan back to a better place. I don't know about Coop. I'm still on the fence with Coop, y'all. She did a really great job in episode 11, but you know, she has yet to apologize to Spencer, but she apologized to Mo, and I know that something bad is about to happen to her, but I'm just really not at the point where I'm looking forward to anything. So I don't have any predictions for Coop for this episode. Y'all drop y'all Coop predictions in the comment section. I'm gonna let y'all handle that. We a team. Y'all got me on that. And then Grace, of course, is going to show up. We've seen her in the trailer talking to Laura. I think she's going to provide the cultural perspective that Laura is going to need in reference to trying to get to a better place of understanding why Olivia did what she did and helping her process that it's not a personal attack on her and that she definitely still loves her mom, but she's being conflicted about where she's at. And y'all, I have to make this video about identity, because that's something I have not talked about yet, but I really do feel like both the Baker twins are struggling with identity and with how they identify within their blackness, and a lot of their decisions also are informed by that fact. So if y'all would be interested in a video detailing that type of stuff, let me know in the comment section down below and I will definitely start working on that, because that's something that's been in the back of my mind for a while. And there you have it. That is my episode 12 synopsis breakdown. I hope you guys enjoyed it. This seemed like it's one of the shorter synopsis. For whatever reason, I feel like it's the least amount of things happening, but the most amount of things actually visually we're gonna see. But tell me if you agree, tell me if you disagree, tell me what your predictions are all down in the comment section below. Again, if you're new here, I'm Erica Vane, and I post new All-American videos every day, sometimes twice a day, and you should really join the tribe by hitting subscribe. I promise you are going to love it here. Just go look at any of my videos, specifically any of my All-American videos in the comment section. You see it? Mad conversation, mad community, mad love. Yes, you want to be a part? Click that subscribe button. Like the video while you're at it. And if you're feeling really froggy and you want to support your good sis E, because I be working hard over here, okay? Me and my team be working hard. Support us by sharing the video on your Twitter, by dropping the link into the Twitter. Tag us at ericavane.com or share a screenshot and tag me at ericavane.com on Instagram. Any way that you could share the content would help me and would be of immense support. And I greatly thank you guys. And if I see it and you tag me, I will always, always respond and always repost you. All right, that's all I got for today's video. I will see you in my next one. If you missed any, the All-American playlist is linked here. And if you're looking for something new to watch, I got two suggestions for you right here. See you in the next one. Bye. How come the stars don't shine when it's day? How come the sky at night makes me this way?